coolant? What is it? What does it do? Why are there so many different types? Is it safe to mix different brands? How can I tell if it's gone bad? What happens if it's never changed? And what one should I use for my car? This time on Road & Race. Everything you could want to know about coolant. What is it? What does it do? Coolant keeps a water-cooled engine at the correct operating temperature. It is pumped through the engine, taking the excess heat with it. It is then cooled via the car's radiators, and the cycle continues. Coolant is mostly water, but not simply water from the tap. Tap water will have minerals in it, which could be bad for the engine, so the water in coolant will have been purified by either being distilled or deionized. The first problem with water is that during a cold winter, it could freeze, so an antifreeze is added to lower the freezing temperature. Also, water helps metal rust, so a rust inhibitor is also added. Lastly, a dye is added to give the coolant a colour. Why are there so many different types? The main difference is the type of rust inhibitor used. There are three main types: inorganic, organic, and hybrid. The inorganic, or IAT type, uses silicates or phosphates as the rust inhibitor, and this will last about 2 years or 24,000 miles before it wears out. The organic, or OAT type, is silicate-free and uses an organic rust inhibitor, such as carboxylate, sebacate, or 2-EHA. It should last up to 5 years or 150,000 miles before it stops working. The hybrid type, as the name would suggest, uses both organic and inorganic inhibitors and also has the extended life of 5 years. As for the colour dye used, it varies between manufacturers, so there's no hard and fast rule, but generally speaking, an inorganic one is blue or green, organic is pink or orange, and the hybrid is violet or red. Also, two different types of antifreeze are commonly used: ethylene glycol and propylene glycol. Ethylene glycol is toxic, but it's more commonly used as it has better thermal properties. Is it safe to mix different brands? Some manufacturers say you can, some say you can't, so to be safe, it's probably best not to do so. If your coolant level is low, the safest option is to simply top up with distilled or deionized water. How can I tell if it's gone bad? There are three tests. 1. Colour. Has it gone all brown and horrible? If yes, change it. 2. Antifreeze protection level. You could buy testers to check the current level of antifreeze protection. Here you can see 5 floating discs, so the coolant will only freeze if it's below 37 degrees centigrade, so it's fine for use here in the UK. Expect to pay roughly £5 for ones that check one type of antifreeze, and about £20 or more for ones that can check both types. 3. Rust protection. Whilst you can buy kits that can test IAT or OAT coolants, I've not been able to find any that aren't either expensive or hard to get here in the UK. If you do know of any, let me know in the comments and I'll put it on the screen here. So my way of testing the rust protection level left is to simply check the car's handbook or service history. If, for example, the change interval is 4 years and it's been 4 years since a coolant change, then simply get one done. What happens if it's never changed? Probably quite obvious by now, but the antifreeze and rust protection will wear out, which will risk the water freezing in the cold and the engine and radiator corroding from the inside. What one should I use for my car? Ah, the million-dollar question. You can either look in your handbook or manual, or you can look on the back of the bottle. Most will detail which cars are compatible. Remember, it's always safer to flush your engine with distilled or deionized water first before replacing with new coolant. Next time on Road & Race. Anyone who's taken their UK driving test will remember having to memorize how far a car will travel when stopping from different speeds. This list was written over 40 years ago and we thought, just how do these figures compare if you tried it out in real life? If you found this video useful, please subscribe and hit the like button as it really helps us make more shows. Click the suggested box at the top of the screen now to watch the next video in this series. Please feel free to get in touch by leaving a comment on this video, and you can keep up to date with us via our website, Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Thanks for watching.